Alright, man, so working on this maze generator still. This is version 2. So much improvement here. You can see that there's a lot more dead ends in this kind of maze generator. Because it actually does that every periodically. Periodically, the maze generator will back up and go, I'm leaving a dead end here, back up, and continue along its path and do some other stuff. So this creates very interesting overworld. And you can see there's a lot of little places where you have to, like, for example, on this screen of the overworld, you have to be able to get to, like, this or this up here, you actually have to find this lower path to go around. So there's a lot of that in the overworld too. There's parts of screens which are closed off from the other part of the same screen, which creates a really enticing thing as a player. You're looking at, you're running around some overworld and you go, oh, I wish I could be over there. I wish I could be over off across the other side of that river. What's over there? There's going to be secrets. Is there going to be a dungeon over there? Is there going to be other types of enemies over there? What is it? Just fuels the desire to explore, and that's really a lot of what the core of Zelda is about, is exploration. At least the first Zelda, it's really about exploration and progressing by finding items. What's up, Momir? So yeah, Momir, I just started streaming just now, and I'm working on version 3 now of the maze generator. So this is version 2. I did this yesterday. Basically, this is redoing the maze generator so it actually works at a quad level rather than just a single level. And I could have rewrote it by just simply doing a higher resolution maze, but I wanted it to work either way. So I'll show you what I mean. I can actually show either one of these overworld mazes. There's the quad maze, which has 16 different directions on each screen. Then there's the bigger maze, the regular maze, which has only 4 directions on each screen. And so, yeah, I'll show you what I mean. Yeah, it's definitely looking more interesting. And I got some ideas for version 3. So this is gonna be version 3 to make it even more. And hopefully this is the last version I'll be creating. And this new version will actually have styles too. So you'll be able to see. Yo, Ginger Kiwi, what's up? Yeah, this new one will actually have styles, so it won't all be pink like it is now. It'll actually be color-coded for different styles. So there'll be like a mountains area. Let me get it running so you can see what I mean. Okay, yeah, so let me turn on showing single and showing the quad. You see what I mean? Yeah, so the big gray lines in the background of this one are the regular path. So you can look at this maze in two different ways, the subdivided way or the general, more bigger paths. So, and the maze, the overworld creation happens at both levels. So yeah, that's also what makes it really interesting. So yeah, and also what I'll be doing today is adding styles. So for example, there'll be some part of this overworld will be mountains. It's just, or maybe a mountain, you know what I mean? So I'll find the center point of the mountain and then create some mountains area. And those will probably be all brown or all gray or something like that, backgrounds. And then there'll be an area where there's some lakes and those will be background blue. And then there'll be a sea. And then there'll be like jungles or forests and those will be green. And then it'll be like a dark forest or a dark jungle, and those will be like darker green. So this is going to get way more interesting right here. And so that's what I'm working on right now. Yeah, shorter dead ends. Well, I got an idea for doing better dead ends in this one. So the dead ends in this one are a little bit accidental. Let's turn off this show single. This is kind of a bit of distraction to show this extra layer there. Yeah, so a lot of these dead ends end up being kind of accidental. For example, any one of the ones, like there's one there and kind of in the bottom right. Any of the dead ends which have aren't actually dead ends, so they have a loop-de-loo. Any of the loop-de-loos you see with two exit points or more, those are accidentally turned into not dead ends. So they were intended to be dead ends, but then the maze generator hooked them up twice. And so that's not intentional, but it was kind of accidental, and I kind of liked it anyways. So, but yeah, today I'm actually going to be working on a better dead end generator, which actually pre-place all the dead ends. So what I'm going to do now is place all of the dead ends in there where about where I want them to be. And then I'm going to place actually where I want the lakes to be, because the lakes are pretty important because they actually cut off, they're one of the only things that cuts off area. Oh, is that right? What's up, Alex Pita? Really? Let's see. Did I mess that up with the gray? You said in the lower right corner. Let's check that out. Yeah, it actually does. So the lower right corner has an it's in general. So the bigger gray line is in general. So for example, in the bottom right corner of this image, there is one white area coming in, which mean and there's a possibility of having both or either of them in. So if anything has an opening on one edge, then that is considered open to the gray line. And this is, so that is correct how it does that. The bottom left is a little weird, but it's actually accurate as well. Okay, so I'm going to go right ahead and start working on this newer generator. This is version 3 of the overworld generator. No. Yeah, gray and white are both openings. The gray ones are the bit just bigger openings. It's just showing you in general if there's either of the openings. Okay, so I'm going to turn off the current maze generator, the main phase of the generator. I'm turning that off. And now I'm going to turn on this newer phase generator, where I'm placing just the dead ends first. I'm going to place these across the area and then use the maze generator to fill it in. So this is just an exact staggering of them, so it's one, you know, same exact distance every single time, which means that this getRandF function is probably wrong. So let me debug that. So R is this huge number. Oh. That's a really funny bug. I forgot to cast that to float, not unsigned. Okay, so we got getRand F, which returns a float. Duh. All right, there. So now they should be not exactly staggered. More random than how it feels like it staggers them. Man, I just noticed how much longer it takes to build when Open Broadcaster is running. It's taking forever. Run, 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 run. All right. There we go, but that. That's pretty weird. Yeah, she loved the peacock. Yep. She loved it. That was awesome to see. You know, it's good. I know I did it right when I see my girl smile. So, it's cool. So I'm just playing with the step a little bit, and then really what the point of all this is to see if this is going to work with the new maze generator. And once again, we're really getting a lot of the same steps. That's so weird. I don't like it, but I'm gonna work. I'm gonna save this for later. What I really want to do is see if the new maze generator works that way. Nice, right on. Yep, I like to do a few things like that every once in a while, just to keep the creativity flowing, but do something completely different, and then that really helps me to come back to Songbringer and go, wow, I see things in a different light. It's just like that taking a vacation did. So. Vacation, coming back from vacation, I'm like, wow, I see everything in a different light. What's up, Felix? Howdy, 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 howdy. I'm working on this overworld maze right now. So this is maze version 2. It's more interesting than the first one, but now I'm working on an even more interesting one, which I'm gonna put lakes into it. So the whole point of making these, adding these dead ends manually was to see if it's possible for the maze, what the maze generator will do when it's already got these pre-generated spots or dead ends. So let's turn back on the main generator and see what happens with the entire maze without even closing off. Right now I've opened up some areas, but I haven't closed off whether they were traversed or not. So yeah, you can see this is not exactly working. It's not hooking them up. I could turn off whether they're checking if they're traversed or not. In that case, we can just check if it's been traversed. In fact, I can write this whole function better for each, no, I just need to go, int ox no, I just go add dir d x2 y2. What's wrong with this? Oh, it's size X, size Y. What's up, Betaval? I'm working on a new maze generator. Not a new maze generator, but this is the third pass. So this is the version 2. It's actually really interesting. But what I want to do to version 2 now is add lakes. So these are going to be in preset dead ends. So there's going to be, it's going to, first it's going to generate a pass where it puts in all the dead ends and where it wants the lakes to be. And on the second pass, it goes and generates a maze through all of that, connecting up the dead ends and connecting to the lakes and things like that. And then the third pass, it goes and places all, everything else. So there's three passes to this, and it should create a really interesting overworld. Nice, cool. Glad you agree, yeah. It's definitely looking a lot better. All right, so that will go, that should create same exact maze. Well, no, I won't create the exact same maze. This is the experiment. I don't know what this is going to do. Looks like it's just going to crash or hang. So where's it hanging at? Yeah, it doesn't like that. Okay, so let's rewrite rewrite that function. Valveware, no, it's a really good question. I started this as a hobby, you could say. But yeah, I've always made game engines. I've been a game developer for 20 years. So this is my first game ever doing it all myself. So I do the art, I do the programming, I do the sound. And I started this whole project off on my savings. I was like living off savings, working on this full time. And I developed it for about 4 months, and then I did a Kickstarter for it, and you can check out the Kickstarter and all the info if you want. The Kickstarter was successful, and that's what gave me the funds to continue doing this full-time. So there's the Kickstarter link. So yeah, it's all thanks to the Kickstarter that I'm continuing to do this game full-time. So once again, thank you, Kickstarter backers. Forever and ever. I'm so stoked about Kickstarter and what is possible with crowdfunding in general. It's a really, really cool process. Because so far it's been an incredibly positive experience. So this would be more accurate to write it this way. This is the old way of doing it. If data, this get offset squared, x2, y2, yeah. That should be the exact same maze. Okay, and I see what it can be done to create the maze the way I want it to. So I don't want to do this. This is really cool that that still works. Let's double check that does still work by turning off the new overworld pre this function right here. Turn this off. And this should generate the exact same map that I had in version 2. Yes, I see all the distinct features of version 2. I've kind of got this memorized because I've looked at this so many times. World Wizard. So you enter, this is a procedurally generated game. You enter 6 letters, and that creates your world based on those 6 letters. So yeah, the 6 letters here are Wizard, and that map is always the same. So good. Okay, I haven't broken anything yet. Now I have an idea. If I go and use this same kind of pre-generator right here, but instead of looping over every single quadrant, so basically we're going to leave one quadrant open for these specific dead ends. Okay, let's do one more thing. Let's turn off the dead end generator in the previous version of the algorithm. It would create these dead ends. So that's going to show that it's using these specific dead ends. Okay, those are our dead ends, and it's not connecting to any of them. So I think maybe it would work better like this. If we're at the last quadrant, return or continue. Basically, I want this maze to link up with these dead ends. Almost. We almost got it here. I think we want everything is pointing to that last quadrant. So we need to pick a quadrant to ignore. So So we're going to pick a quadrant at random to ignore. Actually, no, that's not the accurate way to do it. What we want to do is create an actual vector of quadrants that could possibly be Or we can make them all. Dang, there's so many ways to do this. Wistaso, what's up, man? Hey, no, Xcode has nothing to do with my decision about Android. I already have the code written for the Android platform. I've got that all set up because I'm using Rapid Game. Yeah, so if I get the funds, or if the game does well on Steam, like when it's first released, right, and I have all the time and all the money I need to just keep making this game, then, yeah, it'll be pretty easy to port it to Android. The problem, the thing it was time-consuming to port to Android is testing the port. So, you know, I got to go test it, and that's going to take a long time. Test it, fix it, make sure it works, make sure the controls work and everything. So yeah, I just picked Xcode because I'm very familiar with Xcode and I love the way it works in general. And so I'm already used to it. That's why I use Xcode. Good question. So now instead of focusing on a skip direction first, what I want to do is see if I can get this to actually connect right. Is this right? What it is? Q equals 2? Let's turn off the regular maze again. Yeah, almost. Yeah, and that too. Yeah, there's so many different devices you have to test on Android. Okay, so this one last thing we want to go, if quadrant equals 2, continue here. Almost. I need that one last line. Ah, so I think it would be this. There. And the bottom one. Damn. This is much easier to do by hand. Just write this out by hand. There. There's only four of them that are actually being opened up. There. Okay, that's what I was imagining, an L shape. Now, the whole point of that, yeah, it's a macro. It's just, it makes it easier to write that instead of having to write it out every single time. It's here in Kit. It's just a, it's just like that. It loops over each quadrant, just like it's a regular for loop. Okay, so let's turn back on the generator. The whole point of that was to see if the regular maze generator can work with these preset dead ends somehow. Man, I think it actually might need to just be the single two, one single quadrant. It still ignores it. Okay, let's try this another way. Let's go back to the first maze generator. Before it did any of this, it was just drawing some loops. There, we got some loops. Now, what I'm going to try is when it does for each direction. To get any direction, really, it would just be this and the lower byte. No, it's 4 bits. Yeah, the lower 4 bits. It still doesn't want to jump in there and... So what I'm trying to do is get the maze to connect to these preset dead ends. In there, it's not wanting to go and connect the maze. Oh, I think I see why. No, wrong one. There. See if that works. Now it's checking only specific directions to see if they're traversed already. And that broke the entire maze generator. Dang. All right, I think I got another idea. I'm gonna try giving each one of these preset dead ends a little loop-de-loop type of exit point. So right now we should have just the loops, just the dead ends. So we'll choose a random direction. Well, we're going to want to do it. Well, we need to filter that direction, but anyways, So yeah, we can add that direction to the x and the y. Now the quadrant, so for example, if the direction that we want is north, it's the second one, which is going to give us the quadrant northwest to start with. So we'll call quadrant based on the direction that'll give us northwest. And then we want to do the opposite direction, so direction plus 2, and set that to be open. So let's see that. That should give us a little tail off of each one. Okay, yeah, so I did them wrong. I did all of them wrong. It's too far. Oh, it's north. So direction, so for example, oh, it's quadrant plus 2. Right. So that works, but we also need to do the quad open oh, messed that up too. This is D minus 1. No? Oh, man. Let's think this over. We got, this might need to be D plus 1. No. All right, I gotta think this through. I'm gonna get a drink of water. All right, so how much have I done here? 40. So I got 15 more minutes. I'm gonna put 15 more minutes into this. If I can't make much more progress, then I'm just gonna kind of skip it and go on to the other visual task I wanted to do, which was to add all the styles, change their colors, and then if possible, even make it so the Maze Generator does an animation. Okay, so we've got a random direction. We're setting the quadrant open in the current area, so if we have north as our number, we're going to have northwest as our quadrant, and the direction is going north. We're setting that open, and then we're adding dir north So that should give us y plus 1. Now we've got said quad open quadrant D plus 2. So that's going to be quadrant southeast. Northwest, southeast, yeah. And direction south. This looks exactly right. Let's see why that's not working. Okay, stepping into this first one, what's the direction, by the way? We've got a direction 0, that's south. All right, so we got x is 3, y is 0, quadrant southeast, we're going south. All right, this is going to be an invalid one, but so this one's got a y that's negative. It shouldn't be working. Let's see what happens when it does actually run all this. It just returns a 0 offset. That explains that. Let's see the next one. We got x 14, y 0. Let's do the next one. Here we go. 7, 1. This one can't possibly be a wrong direction. So x is 7, y is 1. Direction south. We got quadrant southeast. Now we got quadrant northwest. Yeah, southeast and northwest don't. Those aren't right. If we're at quadrant southeast, which is 0, then we want minus 1 or northeast for the next quadrant. If we're at quadrant southwest going west, we would want southeast, which is minus 1. Okay. So it looks like they need to be minus 1. There we go. Wow, some of these are really weird. But some of them work. It's all the ones that are south facing that are broken. Okay, let's get so first of all, let's actually see if this even works. Okay, so in no way does it want to connect those up. It's ignoring it because of this. This is completely clear squared function. Hey, what's up, Arcane? Yeah, the generation is working great, man. This is the generator version 2, but I've got some ideas for version 3. It's going to make it even better. And what's going to be better is that I can guarantee it to put a certain number of dead ends. Secondly, I'm going to make it so it's going to generate a lake, maybe a couple different lakes. So, and then thirdly, it's going to generate styles. So it's going to generate a whole area where it's going to be a mountain. There's a whole area it's going to be forest. There's a whole area it's lakes. So that's what I'm working on. So this is going to really flesh out the overworld, make it separate, distinct areas, and all of it built with a maze generator that allows you to go and even subdivide up different areas into 16 different walkable paths per area. Yeah, it's going to get better for sure. It is. I can't wait to see those lakes, you know what I mean? I can't wait to get to the point where I can see run around in the game and be like, yes, it put a lake right here. Or, all right, here's the mountain, you know? I can't wait to do that. But it's gonna take some work to get to that point. It might take 2 or 3 days until I get to that point where it's gonna be version 3. But how much time do I have left today to continue doing this code? About 5 more minutes to see if I can get it to connect the dots. Actually, I think this is supposed to be D plus 2. Maybe that's what it was supposed to be. That wasn't it either. Okay, I think this function is messed up because it's adding the direction first. So if the current x is good, current y is good, and the quad is open. In the direction you want to go, it should be like, yo, go ahead, open it up, right, the maze right there. I think that should be it. Ah. All right. I got to come back to this tonight. This is kind of pissing me off. This isn't working as I thought. This is a tricky thing, creating a maze generator. Okay. Let's go back to the original algorithm. Let's go back to original dead ends. Yeah, totally, right? Yeah, I know what you mean. Yeah, like leaving some areas stranded and stuff. Yeah, I like that idea too. I could even put whole like runs of areas as being stranded, you know, like you can't get to this area. Okay, so I'm just commenting out all this. Save this for later tonight, where I will get this going. And my goal for tonight is to get that working. So it adds in dead ends, it adds in lakes, mountains, rivers, all this stuff. So this should be the old algorithm, version 2. Yeah, okay. I like this. This is a really good place to start from. Now what I'm gonna do, instead of working on those whole algorithms, I'm just gonna work on the art side of it right now. I'm gonna actually make it so this turns into many different sub areas like mountains, lakes, rivers, waterfalls, and all of these are gonna have different colored backgrounds so you can see at a glance what sections the overworld has. It's probably gonna be a lot. It's probably gonna be more like 2 or 3 days. Yes, yeah, I did for now. Yeah, I didn't scrap it. I was just in the process of redoing the whole maze generator, and they suddenly went away. And I was like, you know what? I like it better this way, anyways, because I can always add back in inaccessible rooms later. And so yeah, the point is to really have a maze generator that works the first time. And then if necessary, I can go and make it add inaccessible stuff and secret areas and stuff like that. Okay, let's do this. Let's do random. Randomize all the styles. I know there's 13 styles. This is a total hack anyways. I'm just setting a bunch of random styles so that I can go and work on the visual part of it. So it's going to visually show me on the maze generator, the overworld scene, that what the maze styles are like too. Okay, I'm going to initialize a map with all the colors this is going to use, so we create this map similar to how I create components here. Use this create map. So we have a style type. And on the right, we have color 3B. Let's call this color map. So we got K style light jungle bridges. That's color 3B. Let's give it a green color for the bridges. What's up, Slow Excellence? Okay, so this. Let's get this. Get a green color that complements this pink. Wait, does it matter? Probably not. Seventy-two, 138, 67. So there we go, a greenish color. Now, the other jungle things, we're going to make them the exact same color for now. Sweet, yeah. Thanks, Low Excellence. Yeah, definitely been busy. How about you? How are you doing? Excellent. Have you been excellent? Oh, dang. Difficult people. Difficult people. I what you mean, man. I'm sorry you had to deal with that. So we got dark jungle. Dark jungle is just like darker green. 5,249. Mountains, let's get like a brown. One hundred 76,49. Right. Oh man. Oh, you work help desk. Yeah. That's the job, right? I mean, it's nice if people aren't being difficult, I imagine. I did it once. I did have a part-time job for a while, many years ago. All right, so all the water ones, those are easy. We just want them to be blue and brighter. 74, 96, 148. Oh yeah, right? Okay. Okay, so I'm going to draw a totally different kind of grid. Proton Gaming, what's up? So we're going to loop over every quadrant. For each quadrant per maze area, we've got a quadrant queue, and that is going to give us we're going to get the style for that quadrant. Yeah, almost done with the game. Good question. No, 6 months. 6 months at least. Yeah, style is maze.getStyle for XY quadrant. Yay. Okay, and we can get the color. Yeah. Whew. Man, I know how you feel. Dude, oh my gosh, the last whole year of my life before making Songbringer, I was the brokest I'd ever been. And I never had like scraped by financially so bad before in life. And man, just to be able to have enough to pay my bills every single month to make this game is such a dream come true. Once again, thank you, Kickstarter, and thank you, everybody who backed the Kickstarter for Songbringer. All right, so we're gonna set the color for this based on the style. So, color equals color map style. Doesn't like that. Yeah, what's your question? I hope I can help you. What's wrong with that? Style type, color 3B. Wait, is that because it's const? Oh yeah, you can't use this operator with a const map, which is weird. Anyways, okay, so we'll, yeah, if this is one of these odd grids, then we're gonna go color equals apply tone color. So we'll just darken this tone a little bit. If it's an odd tile. So you're designing a logo with fonts, with Photoshop, convert the fonts to a shape, export the logo, SVG, put it on the web page, and it's empty. I have no idea. I haven't ever used this convert the fonts to shape tool in Photoshop. I mean, I'm familiar with Photoshop as far as like doing pixel art, but I know how to use the text tool and stuff too, but I've never done that thing where you convert it to a shape. And I've actually never used SVG files on the web. So, man, sorry I'm the wrong guy to ask about that one. But if somebody else here on the stream can't help, then I would say try, you know, like Stack Overflow or Webmasters. Is it Webmasters dot Stack Exchange? Yeah. Yeah, if you can't find your answer, I'd definitely recommend that. But you probably already know about that site. Oh, okay. Yeah. Sorry about that. I wonder why that didn't work. All right, cool. So, while that's compiling, we'll let this, we'll start with this other stuff. So that should work, add dir F. The hell? Oh well. Here, let's make one more function. Add dir F. I mean, this is meant to be a convenience method, so it should be convenient, right? Add dir. Vec2. There. Right? What's up, King? Nothing in Xbox, Taco? There, we got addir QP. QP. Tell me that works. Because that should work. Oh, this is so horrible. What the hell? No matching function call? My ass. What? Yeah, nope, nothing big happening. I'm just working on this new maze generator. So this is version 2 right here. And I'm working on version 3, which is going to be more interesting and create. It'll show mountains, it'll show lakes, it'll show rivers and everything. It'll be even more interesting and better than this one. Right. The joy. Okay. What's up, Cat Pinch? Yes, Cocos 2D is powerful. I use Cocos 2D X. It's different than Cocos 2D. It's a cross-platform library. All right, screw this. Let's do this the old school way. PX 0 or OX. Oh, I think I see what's wrong. Oh, I know what it is. This is supposed to be quad or dir. There. No, no worries, man. If you're looking at like how to get started in game development, check out the FAQ. It's like this little link here on my live stream. Click on the info for it, and then I give you kind of like a here's how I would get started in game development type thing. You're welcome, you're welcome. Okay, so P.x now has the direction that we're going with this quadrant. All right, so P times P.x times equals AW times a half. Actually, these are supposed to be 1, 1. P dot y plus equals ah times a half. And then p dot x plus equals x times aw. And this is p dot y times ah. There. Okay, cross your fingers, hope this works. If it works, we'll have a lot of different colors on the screen. Man, it took a long time to code that. All I wanted to do was change these colors. But yeah, it is breaking it into quadrants, so I guess that's kind of takes time. All right, so it started doing it kind of right. Oh, this is wrong too. Okay, so quadrants. One more time. I gotta change this. Okay, so I need to create a function now that converts a quadrant into basically a float or int. So quadrant Q, float ref X, float ref Y, Northwest, Y plus plus, northeast, and southeast. There, now we got an add quadrant function. We can use that in scenes here. So that should take away that sort of patchwork look and create it so it's each area is subdivided into four different sub-screens with different styles, which will create different colors in each one. So it'll be less like checkers, more like a blanket or a quilt. Damn it, still doesn't work. All right, let's see. Set a breakpoint there and just start paying attention to the math, figure out what's wrong with the math. All right, so we got very first one. Quadrant should be what? Quadrant is southeast. Okay. Why is x 15, 7? Oh, it's working backwards. Okay, that's fine. It's quadrant. We've already got p dot x, p dot y. It should be x is 2. No. Okay, this is southwest. Nothing happens to X or Y. Northwest, nothing happens to X. Northeast, both are increased. And southeast, just the X. Oh yeah, and then this P should start at 0. Ah, there we go. Awesome. Yay, finally. Okay, good. We've got it started, so it's showing us the pink thing is the home screen. All the green stuff is forest. The dark green stuff is a dark forest. The brown stuff is mountains. The blue stuff are lakes. So it's all randomized right now. Next step is to get it so it's patterned. It's like, it looks sort of like Zelda, for example. Zelda's Overworld. I hope that's a recent. Here's one of Zelda Overworlds. Here, this one. Yeah, so there's plenty of green areas. So if this were an overworld, all these green areas would be green grass and stuff. So it's the next thing, getting them to be patterned like that. So let's put in two lakes with styles. Back to the maze generator. Okay, so it looks like we are going to need case style none. So let's set a center point for each lake. Now I'm taking a quick break. Alright, so I just realized what's wrong with the black things there. What's up, Gru Buck? Oh, yeah. That happens so often. Twitch going crazy. Oh, yeah, these random styles right here. Should be one plus. Okay, so let's add in some manual lakes. Yeah. Okay, so let's put one lake at like let's just do these manually first. Ah, there you go. Cool. So yeah, okay, so I'm trying to create just some round lakes. It's really just simple. They're 9 tiles per. Set some manual positions for these. So let's do 5, 3 for the first one, and we'll do 7, 4 for the next one to do sort of like a staggered lake, sort of. No, let's do 5, 4, 7, 3 there. So that, okay, so we're gonna loop over each one of these two positions and create some lake styles around these two positions. And that's okay. Okay, now everything. I think we can call set 4 styles for p.x, p.y. This is totally written wrong. Okay, set 4 styles. Doesn't need a quadrant. All right, it's a way easier function anyways. It's nice to have things get shorter and shorter and shorter with this newer maze generator. It's pretty cool. Set four styles, of course, is going to be messed up. So this call right here, this is wrong. This is supposed to be set style. XY quadrant style. XY quadrant style. Yeah, so that's not supposed to be set four styles. But this is this one here, P.X, P.Y, style type K. Style lake. There. Okay, so this should force just two areas so far to be K style lake entirely. All four quadrants. And then we'll fill in the lake around that. Cool, I'm glad we don't need that anymore. All right. Okay. Oh, man. Oh, yeah. Oh, it worked. Oh, super cool. Okay, so those two, let's set it now so it's a little more distinct because so it makes it so it doesn't randomly choose a blue. Since I'm not gonna end up actually using this code right here, I'm gonna make it really ugly. So once again, this is super janky right here what I'm doing. But once again, I'm not going to be using this in my game eventually. I'm just doing it for right now. Okay, style waterfall. Okay, now we're just selecting a style. So that should randomly select any style except for water. Yeah, cool. Okay. Now we've got two distinct lake start points. Let's get them connected and add some water around them. Okay, I think this could actually be done with compass directions. So auto D equals K dir south. D is less than K num compass directions. D plus plus. Doesn't like that. D equals compass dir D plus one. What's up, Grim Gary? I know. Yeah, Grubuck, once again, I'm not ever, this is not production code. I'm not going to use this in my game. So this will be deleted as soon as I can get the all of this stuff filled in. So I'm just doing that the quick and easy and dirty way. Which, you're right, this whole while statement is horrible. Yo, Fung, the painting turned out great, man. Yep. You saw it at the right there at the end, though. Same exact thing. My girl loved it. So, yeah, that was cool. If anybody was just joining the stream, I painted on Sunday. And I live streamed the painting of just, I painted a peacock. And so it was totally different than late game development, but it was still a creative task. So it got my mind going good. Yeah, thanks, Grubuck. Oh, you know what? I think that happens. People always say that, but I think it's because I'm, yeah, see, like, I don't know. Yeah, it's just the lighting. It's just the lighting. I'm on a poor quality, you know, the camera on my laptop's not that awesome. So, okay, so this is where we could do we're going to get a vector for the current direction. Compass direct, no, vector from compass direction D. So that'll give us all, that'll give us like, okay, if, yeah, okay, so we've got two options. One, we're going to set both. So if the direction mod 2 equals 0, these are all the main compass directions. Is where we're gonna set the two styles. So this is p dot x plus, let's see, this is called vec. So p dot x plus v dot x. That's P dot y plus v dot y. Quadrant is, all right, so this is where, so, for example, if the direction is south, then we want the quadrants to fill in north, east, and northwest. So that's, northeast and northwest, plus 2. So this is quadrant D shifted down 1 plus 2. Okay, style water. Lake, whatever. Lake. Yeah. This is quadrant D shifted down 1. So for south, once again. Plus 3. Yeah, 2 and 3. So this is the main compass directions. This is the diagonal compass directions. This is where we're only going to set one style. And that's going to be, yeah, still p dot x plus v dot x. Now, okay, so if the direction, So, like, the direction is southwest. That's going to give you a 1. And so 1 plus 1 No, wait. If we had directions southwest, which is 1, shift that down 1, we got 0. And then we add 2. I think that's what it is. Same thing here. Okay, let's try that. What I'm trying to do now is create a thicker lake, but not so thick that it covers up 9 areas, but half of the 9 areas. Okay, cool. Okay, so we got a flower shape going. Now we just screwed up on the diagonal ones. The diagonal ones, gotta fix those. So let's see what it's trying to do, and then we'll figure out what it's actually doing. Okay. Groobug, no, you cannot. You cannot bit shift what are they called? You can't bit shift a strongly typed enum, but what I've got here is this quadrant function to allow me to play with quadrants. So basically, I can take a quadrant as an integer, and if it goes one beyond the end of the quadrant, it mods it by the number of quadrants and then static casts it back into a quadrant. So this integer q could be anything at all. And it'll get converted accurately into a quadrant. And so I do the same thing with directions. And so that's just a safeguard, but allows me to play with it. So like if you go one off the end, it shifts back to the beginning. Yeah, that is the bit shift operator, but I'm using an integer. Or no, I'm treating it as an integer. So basically any kind of enum in C++ can be converted to an integer. So that's what's going on here. And what's inherently happening in this line of code is this d is getting converted into an integer, shifted down 1, added 2, and then added back into this quadrant integer. The reason is it's inherently, or is it, the word isn't inherently, I don't think, but the reason it is inherently turning it into an integer is because quadrant takes an integer. See that? This quadrant function takes an integer, so the compiler is smart enough to know that it needs to convert all this down into an integer. And it's okay to cast enums into ints. Okay, so let's go. Right, so what is the D? The direction is southwest, right? The first quadrant we would have come across, it's in the corner. Nope, yeah, nope, yep, you're right. There's no operator. Nothing weird going on there. Okay, so southwest. Let's see what happens with that. The quadrant Q is 2. That's 1. Yeah, down to quadrant 2. It should return. Step into this method. Quadrant Q is northwest. What the heck? Nice. Right, so I want to back up a function where it's going to generate overworld. What's P again? P 5-4. V. Oh, that's what it is. So when we actually get into the set style, we've got 4-3. No, that's actually right. But we can guarantee that it's right by doing CLF. That. Oh, that's a good one. Osbury, Barry. OS Barry. Okay, this looks like it's right to me. I don't know why this would be failing, because we got in generate overworld, the direction we had was southwest. We got the X and Y for that. We got the quadrant. It turned out to be quadrant northwest. That's correct. X is 4-3. That's also correct. Okay, let's go to the next one. All right, we got direction northwest this time. Let's guarantee that it's doing that correctly. So if I comment that out, we should have just the sides. It'll look like a flower. Or like a Mario power up. Yeah, okay. That's to be expected. We got those, just those blue areas. So anyways, just tuning in, the goal right here is to create a lakes in this overworld. Just a little rectangular nine areas encompass these lakes. Okay, I guess we do need to turn back on. You know what? Let's just do this. If it's southwest, allow it. Because I've seen that one already and I know that it should work. Why wouldn't it? So that there, we're only doing the diagonal southwest direction. It's just not getting created. I don't get it. Let's try northwest. Or either that or the southwest is. Yeah, let's set the breakpoint here again. There's got to be something going wrong with these diagonal quadrants. Yeah. No, the goal is not to make them actually flower-like. The goal is to actually turn them into rectangles. So they're sort of circular-ish, right? Actually rectangular, but okay, so the P dot X, we've got D southwest, P dot V. Oh, we messed that up. We call this sign. Okay, once again, position is 5-4. Now, cool, now we have a good vector, -1, -1. That's southwest. Okay, step into the method once again. quadrant we're getting back is northwest. The x is now 4, y is 3. That should be diagonally left and down an area. Oh, no, it's supposed to be northeast. Northeast, not northwest. Okay, that's what's wrong. So northwest, northeast is one more. So this is... man, I hate getting lost in code. I wish code editors were a little smarter about, or maybe I was smarter about how to use IDEs so that I didn't get lost so much in my code, jumping back and forth between functions in the same file. That's what always gets me lost. Okay, 3. Sweet, I did it. Okay, now we got that southwest working. Now if we turn this into a comment, we should be able to do the whole circle. Nice. And I noticed during that we can just simplify all this. Falter them? What do you mean falter? Oh, you mean like tab? Or collapse? Do you mean collapse or tab? There, cool. Fold. Yeah, you can fold. Right? You just like go here in this little bar right here and that folds your code. But I don't know, I've never found folding. I guess I should try that maybe. I mean, maybe I should try folding more often. No worries, man. Thank you. Thank you for suggesting that. I should probably try that. Okay, yeah, so that does need this bit of code here. Okay, good enough. We got lakes. Now, it'd be nice to randomly stagger them, but what I'd rather do is add a mountain. So we'll do the mountain center point. Start with that. Mountain center point. Let's do right smack dab in the middle. No, let's do all the way at the top. Top right. We'll do a width I guess about 8. Height, about 4. Let's do a whole height of 8, actually. Let's be bold. Now, actually, these, I don't need to worry about Y2 or anything. That's good. No curly brackets on the for loops? Not a fan. I understand what you're talking about. But once again, I'm going to mention this for like the third time, but this is not code that I'm putting in the end product right here. It's just randomly filling in some styles so we could see what they look like. So, add mountain. Right. So if X is... And then we'll do the same thing here with X, center X minus width, center X plus width. X is greater than 0, greater than equal 0. Y is greater than equal to 0. This set style X, Y, quadrant. No, we need to use set four styles in this one. Set four styles. X, Y, style type, K style. Low mountain. Okay, let's see if that worked. If this works, we're going to see a diamond pattern shape for the mountains. Oh. That was a crazy bug. All right, okay, yeah, we got that whole section now. What we want to do now is make sure that we need to do a line down the center. So X plus Y is less than 0. I'm using the WTF method to code right here. I think that's supposed to be less than 0. Might be need to be greater than 0. I didn't like that. It's me time. What's Songbringer going to be about? Let me show you a little bit about what it's about. Songbringer is a Zelda-like game. It's like Zelda 1. You're this character, this main hero's name is Rock, and then you've also got this friend who's this robot guy. His name is Jib, and he follows you around. He helps you out on your quests and stuff like that. The whole plot is you're part of this spaceship called Songbringer that's cruises around the galaxy looking for planets to party on. So the whole overworld is messed up in this version of the game, but you have a sword, you have all these items, you have these cacti, you eat these cacti and you get psychedelic powers, you can see secret walls. It's basically just like Zelda 1, except it's procedurally generated. That's all there is to it. So I'm working on the procedural generation algorithms right now. That's why the overworld looks so messed up and is so messed up. It's because I'm working on that right now and changing it all. It used to work in a way where each one of these areas would have four definite areas of exit. So you could either go up, you could go down, you could go left, you could go right on each screen. And it always had the same width for the exits and everything. And now we've got this whole thing where now each area is subdivided into 16 different areas of possibility where you can travel on that area. And so it really helps the overworld to be more interesting. And the maze generator is pretty cool because now the maze generator works that way. And so you can have certain areas where you're going to be caught and only be able to go on one, like you'll be like an area will be divided. You'll have one side and another side. You'll be like, whoa, I want to go over there, but you can't get over there. So X plus Y, I think it's X minus Y. What's the what's the equation to make a diamond shape again? I did this once before. Oh yeah, if absolute value is greater than something. Thanks, it's me time. Thank you, man. Okay, yeah, absolute value of X plus absolute value of Y is greater than something, then we continue. And now I think that would just be width. So hopefully that makes a diamond shape. Oh, I see what's going on. This is supposed to be X minus center X. I think that's supposed to be W. Once again, I'm using the WTF method to code right now. This is just the... Oh, look, there. See, it finally worked. Okay, and so I'm going to make this greater than or equal to W. The WTF method eventually works. There, that's all I wanted. Diagonal shape, there, that's the mountain. All those brown areas are now mountain. Now let's go and just throw every single one of the rest of the areas. Let's make some jungle. Okay, there we go. There we go. That's a start. That's a start to this algorithm. So we got green areas. These are jungles. We got the blue areas. Those are lakes. We have the pink area, that's your home screen. You got all these brown areas, those are mountains. So I need to keep working on this because there's a lot left to do. First of all, I need to finish this and get it so the styles are, so for anybody that's just joined or whatever, I'm wrapping things up. This is about it for my videos today, for my live stream. I'm just kind of sharing what happened today and what I'm gonna do tonight. So I'm working on version 3 of the maze generator. River, yes. Definitely needs a river for sure. Let's set this so it's just showing version 3 of the text. There's maze squared version 3 we're working on. So what I'm gonna do tonight is get it so there's a lot more nuance it needs. For example, there's low mountains, there's mid-sized mountains, and then there's the high mountains. There's three types of jungle. There's three types of dark jungle, and there's actually three types of different water, or four types of different water areas. So that's what I need to do. I need to keep finishing this algorithm. And I need to randomize these too. So right now, the two lakes and the mountain are in hard-coded positions. So I need to keep on playing with the algorithm and try different positions where it starts putting things and where it ends up putting things and stuff like that. And then also I'm going to work on the actual maze algorithm. So the white lines you see going over everything, that needs some work too. And that will definitely take some effort to get that correct as well. And so this could be 2 or 3 days away until I'm just settled on this overworld generator working better. And then once the overworld generator's better, then I'll actually go and do the work to make the game play like this. So that's gonna be the fun part, like actually making the areas. If it's jungle and it's a light jungle, it looks like this. If it's jungle and it's cliffs, it's gonna have some cliffs on that jungle. If it's gonna be high mountains, it's way up high and has a background of clouds or whatever and stuff like that. So this is fun stuff. This is really cool to get the maze generator this far, and I'm excited to see what happens next. So that's it for today's video. If anybody's just tuning in right now, this game is called Songbringer and it's coming out in about 6 months for Steam at first, and then it'll come out on other platforms too, like iOS and RetroVGS. But yeah, that's it. So we'll catch you guys next time. Next stream will be tomorrow about the same time, 4 p.m. Pacific-ish. So that's it. Talk to you guys later.